This guy has sold 52 million records, you guys. Is that amazing? He's won 2 Grammys and 6 American Music Awards. All this, and has been named one of the sexiest men alive. Would you please welcome Michael Bolton?
I'm fine. I'm kind of, working a lot, traveling, promoting this classics album.
That's right.
CD is great.
Yeah. Thank you.
Absolutely fantastic. What are your plans? What did you do for New Year's? What are your plans?
Well, I'm going to be on an island. I have a performance, a private show I'm going to do in San Juan, Puerto Rico. And before that, I'm going to take my kids on vacation and go to a warm, private place and relax.
The whole Y2K thing, everybody's all worried about it now. You know, the clock is just about ready to tick to 2000. Are you concerned about it?
Extremely. I can't sleep at night over this.
Are you serious? Really? You are
not. Oh, get out of here. Get out of here.
Okay, Michael. All right, Michael. All right, I wasn't going to go here, but I'm going to now.
All right.
You know Tommy and Tommy Nast?
Sure.
Good friend of mine.
Yeah, great
He helped
guy.
You get started. You used to do your laundry over at their house.
Oh, I thought you said he used to do my laundry. He wouldn't like
that. No, no, no.
It's probably true. I mean, no, we're old friends.
And, yeah.
When I used to come out here, and I could hardly afford a hotel room, you know. So it was a while ago.
He said you have terrible luck at the horse races.
That's right. That's right.
Uh-huh.
The one time I went, I cannot believe you're talking about this.
I know these things.
He convinced me to go to the races. I went to the races. I finally won one race and had the wrong ticket. I got stung in the head by a bee. I thought somebody dropped hot ashes in my head. You know? Some people don't like long hair. I used to have long hair. You know?
This was all in one day at the races.
This is one day. There were other things that happened. I can't even tell you.
Well, okay, your rider fell off the horse.
Oh, yeah. One.
Okay, you gotta help me out here. Help me out here.
I'm scared.
Michael.
Y2K is nothing compared to this.
Hey, I am Y2K.
Okay, help me out here. Who is Tommy Nast?
Tommy Nast was the editor and part owner of a really big album network radio magazine.
Okay, so he's in the business.
Many times.
My girlfriend Patty knows them very well.
I see.
That's how I found out
great,
all this.
Really, yeah. Really great person. This is quite some time ago.
She knows so many things about people.
I'm terrified.
Oh, I know something
so
else.
Here. What do you think I go through here?
Why
well, you know, pay? Michael Bolton doesn't come on your show every day.
I'm not invited every day.
Hey, you're invited anytime you want.
I'll be back then.
Okay.
What do you have there?
This feels good. You got a great crew. Everybody back here. Everybody's
Thank
friendly.
You.
Everybody's nice here. It's really, it's pleasant. It's
you know what? It is fun, and they are a great crew.
Mm-hmm.
People magazine quoted you. It says, an evening, this is what you like, an evening
I have to go.
With someone, an evening with someone very special would start with snuggling by the fireplace with lots of pillows.
I said that?
You said it, Michael.
Did you say it?
Not is that true?
Not exactly. I didn't say it exactly that way.
Well, how would you
I was
say
edited.
It? You were edited?
Yes.
Well, they took out the rest of it, huh?
they just put their favorite parts together.
So who would that lucky woman be now?
Right now, I'm sorry to say there is no that lucky woman.
No, wait a minute.
That's part of why
Don't
I came
say
on
that.
The show.
Don't say that. You got a chance.
I thought maybe you guys could help me out on the show. So.
Yeah,
sure.
So you have room for an 800 number I can put on?
Yeah, Michael, we hear you need a lot of help.
Uh-huh. Yeah, right, sure. you mentioned earlier your daughters. How old are your daughters now?
My oldest daughter is 24.
Get out.
I just got
When
here.
Did you start? The 5?
Oh, 24, 22, and 20. I'll tell you.
The band's on the floor. No, how old are they again?
24.
24, 22, and 20.
20.
Wow.
Yeah. I was 5 when I had my first
one. Exactly.
Uh-huh. It's a good thing I didn't know what caused it.
Yeah, right.
So what kind of a father are you? What do you, you know,
just
it's
call my kids up and find out.
No, I'm saying, like, you get involved with their lives now that they're older. Do you get involved in the dating process? And
yes, I actually interview everyone who comes in.
No,
you do?
Are you serious?
Yeah, we have a metal detector in front of the house. And, no, you know, I built a recording studio next to the house so I could be home at dinner time for the first time in many years.
Yeah, that's terrific.
So at 6:30, religiously, every night, 6:30, the phone rang. It was my middle daughter, Holly. I'm on my way over. You know, and whoever was producing the record with me or working on our way over to the house. And I remember I had producer Mutt Lang, you probably know who.
Mutt Lang, absolutely. Talented producer.
He came up, he married Shania Twain. And, that's an incredible story. But he sat at the table and said, looked around and said, "Do you know that you're completely surrounded by women all the time?" And I looked around, I had my three daughters, the nanny, and the cook. Because I can boil water, but I usually burn it. And I realized, this is basically, and then the women next door in the office all run my office, they run my business, basically. So I'm surrounded by women all the time.
So you're more comfortable around women?
I am very comfortable around
women. No, but see, he says that women run his business. This is a smart man.
I thought you'd like to know that.
Yes.
But my daughter, so anyway, at dinner, you know how much gets exchanged, you know. But there are things, men just are so unaware of what's going on with women in general, let alone younger women.
I knew I loved you.
Between 15 and 19, if you have daughters, you probably know this, something happens that...
Yes, I think we know.
But
we know all about
that,
Michael.
I gotta tell you, though, I was prepared for it because I saw The Exorcist, part one and part two. So. I was prepared for it.
A lot of estrogen. Yeah.
And I needed women around me to explain what just took place at the kitchen table. why one daughter stormed out of the room and the other one said, "Well, I'm glad she left." You know, nothing was said at the table. "Well, you weren't paying attention, Dad." "I'm just going to eat my food."
You know. Hey, Michael, before we go to commercial break here, briefly tell us about the Michael Bolton Foundation. And you've specified women and children at risk are the people who benefit from this. Can you explain that?
We raise money for shelters and for organizations who assist women and children at risk. And at risk means women and children who are in some sort of danger, immediate danger.
Such
either
as?
Domestic violence. Or poverty, a lot of times basically just thrust them into really dangerous situations. And what we found is that they get brought into shelters and then released weeks or a month or so later, right back into the same situation.
Yep.
So we've brought in these family advocates to work with them. And we work with Yale University, the Yale Child Study Center, and other organizations to bring in people who sit with the families, sit with the mothers, give them living skills that they didn't have.
Where do people find these shelters?
Well, I live in Connecticut, and they're all throughout Connecticut. It's not just about being in poor sections. The very affluent, areas have a lot of people going through tough situations.
Well, we will put those on our website if you are curious about that. And I say a lot of people get involved in charities, but it's really nice to see somebody who really gets down to the grassroots levels and really helps people.
It's nice to be able
to break that pattern. That's the best thing about it. You break that pattern. Michael? You can't get away from our show without singing, obviously, right? So, when we come back, Michael Bolton is going to sing for us, so stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back. We're here with Michael Bolton. I would imagine, Michael, you've got some crazy fan stories over the years.
Me, nah.
Oh, yeah, right.
You love the road.
I do love the road.
Yeah.
I mean, I like being out there. I think that's the most gratifying part of what you do because it's, all the work that, goes into building a career.
Yeah.
And I think that touring is kind of the harvest of all that work because you're out there performing. You're actually realizing it's about singing. And you look in the audience, and the audience knows the words better than you do.
I know. Which been there, been there, done
they're
that.
Gonna bust
you forget the words, and they help
but
you.
But they laugh.
But you do forget them.
But what's the what's
really
a crazy
do.
Fan story? The first thing that comes to mind.
One I can talk about?
No, I want the one you can't talk
yeah,
about.
Yeah, we want that one.
You know, fans are capable of anything at any unexpected time. I mean, you know, it's interesting to be flashed by fans, you know.
You've been flashed.
No.
Tops up and off.
Hey!
Now stop that.
I mean, last time it happened, I said, Mom, you shouldn't be doing that. No, but
well,
she's a real joker, that mom.
Michael, you got to sing for us. Yeah! You got to sing for us. Come on, bud. The stage is waiting. The mic is ready. Now, I gotta tell you, I was listening to his rehearsal today when he was singing Sexual Healing. What a voice. What a
CD,
voice.
CD, this is part two, and we were just talking earlier that part one sold over, what was it?
Seven million
copies. Is that amazing?
He is going to sing the Marvin Gaye classic, Sexual Healing. Please give a big welcome. Michael Bolton.
Baby, I'm hot just like an oven. I need some loving, yeah. Baby, I can't hold it much longer. It's getting stronger and stronger. And when I get that feeling, I want sexual healing. Sexual healing, baby, it's good for me. Sexual healing is something that's good for me. Whenever I'm blue teardrops are falling, and my emotional stability is leaving me.
Of my body and